So will you, can write directly to Bob, and would you put your letter up on the website? That would be very interesting, you can actually read it. Are you happy with that?
Yes.
The last one is from Susan McLaughlin, is she here? It's a really good suggestion about a station in Prenton. And I wondered whether the Prenton councillors and Andrew, whether we could, through you, with you, write to Mersey Travel to the chairman of it and say it may not be in your plans at the moment, but it should be, when might it be? And that we would, and that we'd look at that part of Mersey Travel's investment budget in new stations and look to see where they're actually investing. How many new stations this side of the river compared with how many new stations in the next 5 years the other side of the river. So we might try and push ourselves up on that list.
Yeah.
Anything else on that?
I mean, in terms of, we did have a presentation from Mersey Travel, and there was three areas where they were potentially looking at kind of new stations in the future, but it was only potentially. So one of those areas was Woodchurch, wasn't it? One was Town Meadow, wasn't it? And Beechwood was third, yeah.
Right.
So, but I mean, certainly can make the, the suggestion about, you know, that they include Prenton in that as well.
There's exciting times ahead, really, for we've just put out to what you call OG notice is the replacement of the rolling stock. Now that is aimed at transforming and increasing the passenger numbers. But what is also available with the new trains when they come online is that they will be able to, the technology will allow them for nearly 100 miles to actually travel without electricity because they have storage batteries, if you like, on it. So it does open up the possibility of getting more passengers. More passengers will then make the case for more numbers of people, and it would be a vital link to the commuter sort of setup. So they are on the list, but things have to follow a reasonable path. But it's no point, no harm in asking and keeping it on top of the agenda.
And Neil Robertson was concerned with that big contract, where possible, it would be actually used British companies. There's this whole business about European competition. Now, Boris managed to get round this. So I asked Boris whether the officers who negotiated the cross-rail contract in London could speak to Liam's officers here, so we could keep within the law, but also keep the contracts when they are put out to British firms. But we'll follow that up with Liam and Logan. All right.
Yeah.
There are two other items here. One is a report back from St Paul's Community Hub. Jo?
I've spoken to the head teacher, Chris Benner, at St Paul's Community Hub, and she's done a monitoring report for us, and the summary of that is there's £25k been invested in from the Public Health Innovation Fund into St Paul's Roman Catholic School in Beechwood. And the main areas that the investment has taken place is an outdoor garden, which is a climbing frame, an activity trail, bird feeders, and other enhancements to do outdoor sort of stimulating play in the garden for the twos and the under twos. They're also working with the Catholic Children's Society as part of this project, supporting families and vulnerable families and doing parenting projects. Specifically around speech and language, which is an area that is a lot sort of less well developed than other parts of the Wirral. They've also got speech and language therapists going into the school hub as well, trying to bring the under twos up to the same benchmark as the rest of the Wirral. They're collating extensive data as well using the Welcome system, which measures progress of children in their communication, and they also measure general school readiness and are capturing anecdotal evidence of impact from parents. They're engaging with the wider community as well. There's the big local initiative in Beechwood, which has £100,000 of funding for 10 years, so £1 million over 10 years. So they're linking much of that and seeing how some of the wider than just parents and the children into the community hub, and they're looking at ways of sustaining it after the funding is finished. And they're also linked into the area-based community development initiative, which is about empowering community members to be community champions and taking on the work of the community hub in the future.
We also run a school as well. I was in the school the other week because I met this at the beginning, Joe. The Foundation Years Trust, which I chair, which the council's very generously supporting, has some of those activities are actually at that trust's activities about trying to improve school readiness, and that's one of the big areas where it's very interesting. Italy and starts pointing our whole projects on breastfeeding and so on. But it's a lovely school to go into. The other part, Liz, I didn't actually see you there when we were doing feeding at Birkenhead. Do you want to say what was happening at Tranmere? Sorry, I've got the wrong name. It's Lynn.
Yeah. I don't know, I can do.
Liz, do tell us what you were doing. It was really interesting. I came and visited you.
Oh, over the summer?
Yes, over the summer.
Pretty much what you do, really. We were one of seven schemes that provided, I think,